Howdy everyone, welcome to Jerome, Arizona. Today we're at the Gold King Mine, a little ghost town tourist attraction here, about a mile outside of Jerome, here to see some old mining relics. They've got some Americana sprinkled in here. It's gonna be a lot of fun, so let's go check this place out. This place has a lot of character. So we just came into the gift shop. We're gonna check out the stuff. There's a lot of merch in there, but there's a wide range of pricing in here. Amy and I, for ages 13 to 64, it was $7 a person. I'm gonna put information on our website at cactusatlas.com. Check out the page for this and you'll find everything you need to know. So this place is an actual old mine. It was mined in the late 1800s into the early 1900s. There was a small population that lived here. So this is a good indication of things yet to come. Look at all this paraphernalia here, all this rusty iron. Looks like the front of, like, I guess, furnaces and all sorts of stuff. I'm already a little overwhelmed. Just look at this collection of antique vehicles. That is so cool. I almost don't even know where to begin. Look at this. Look at this. Some kind of, I'm sure nobody's ever flown that, but wouldn't that be awesome? What do we have up here? Looks like you can actually go into some of these buildings here. Is this a laundry room? Very old rickety building here with lots of old stuff, an old cash register in here. Old cans all over. This place is just covered in stuff all over the place. Old car parts, looks like old gas station equipment. Check this out. Sneak back here in between the buildings too, and you can get a good view of down below. You can actually see the red cliffs of Sedona off in the distance. You can see, I mean, these structures have definitely seen their age. I couldn't tell you how old or how original these are. I don't see any signage telling us anything about them, but they look like the real deal, don't they? All right, let's go into this little gas station here. Whoa, you feel that floor moving, I'll tell you that. Oh, look at all this stuff in here. Wow. I'm assuming we can head out here on this porch. I honestly am questioning the structural integrity of this place. This is old. It's a good view though from back here, isn't it? Looks like there's an old jail hiding out over here. Can we go in? I think we can. Well, no we can't. That does not, that does not move, and I thought I was gonna bring that whole thing down. You could see here on this building, the word Haynes used to be big enough to have its own post office back in the day. So people actually did live here on the premises. And there's a mining facility, a mine shaft over there that we're gonna take a look at. But I don't think these were actually buildings that were here originally. Now I could be wrong. The lady in the gift shop did say some of these were actually moved here from a different location and brought here. So it's hard to really discern what's what. There's really no signage indicating what these buildings really were, where they came from. That'd be really interesting to know though. And this whole collection of antique trucks and cars is just endless. It just keeps going and going. Cannon Salvage and Towing. Think they're still in business? Having a hard time making out that sign there. Looks like there were a couple different things painted on there at some time. Take a peek in here. I'm trying to get up there to take a look at that old structure. It looks like something from the old west. There is a sign that says do not enter. So I don't know if we're gonna get any closer to that, but that is a very old looking structure there. Stop and caution rattlesnakes. Yeah, that looks like a kind of place the rattlesnakes would like. The structures here, the buildings are really, really cool. This one in particular, I still am a little frustrated though, just because I want to know like where they came from, how old are they? And unless I overlooked it somewhere, there's no pamphlet or anything to really tell you what this stuff is, nor any signs. That would make this place a little bit more interesting to me, is if I knew a little bit more about what these things, for all I know, maybe these things were built in the 60s or 70s or something and have just decayed over time. Who knows? Probably not. But yeah, looks really authentic though, doesn't it? There are a few folks here. It's actually a Monday. We specifically came here. We had some time off from work and we wanted to come here thinking, oh, we'd escape the crowds. Jerome can be pretty touristy and parking can be kind of a pain in the butt in Jerome proper. So we came up here to film this. And yeah, you do get a little bit away from the herd. If you do find that you're having trouble finding a parking spot in Jerome and just don't want to mess with that for a little bit, come up here and cool down your head. And there's very interesting junk everywhere, just strewn about. It's really hard to take it all in a good way. And if you're in the market for a slab, looks like they sell them here. Maybe you're making a bar or a table or benches. It's pretty cool. Oh, this is really cool. It's like an old candy machine, like a gumball machine. Now I am in the market for an off-road vehicle this year in 2020, and I think I found what I want. That is really awesome. It's always nice to kind of climb up the hill here and get a different perspective of everything down below. This is the old Yavapai County District fire truck. That's an antique right there. Old wooden seats, very comfortable. And look at this old Coca-Cola sign. I really like these fire trucks a lot. Idlewild Fire Department. Oh, look at this old Shell oil truck. Assume it hauled gasoline. That's an oldie. So these cars are much better restored than what you see out in the junkyard over there. Assume that's why they're here outside of the elements a little bit. A 1902 Studebaker electric. There's just so much stuff. Just when you think you've seen it all, there's all these nooks and crannies to explore. It's just, yeah, I still have not found the end of it yet. I just heard some goats behind me and there you have it. I think that might be like a petting zoo. I read about that. So you may be able to enter there and pet, I'm not sure. I hear chickens too. Is this the chicken coop? Looks like it. There's fresh eggs in here and boy, smells farm fresh. Oh yeah, it's the old chicken coop. Hey guys. Some ducks. I'm being surrounded, I think. Hey guys, how's it going down there? Sunning yourself? We got chickens all over the place in here. That's some big ones, look at that. Some other really old looking buildings here. Once again, not sure just how old.
Yeah, this place is totally a labyrinth. I haven't been on this like layer. I was down a hill over there and over that way. Haven't explored any of this part yet, and there's just so much to see here.
Looks like you can actually enter the barn. You got a couple of coffins over here and just a bunch of stuff. A bunch of Americana. All sorts of chainsaws. If you're looking for a chainsaw, this is where you want to go. An old fire extinguisher here. You long-haired freaky people need not apply. It's from a song, guys.
Too much to take in.
This looks like an old schoolhouse. That's pretty cool. Those are definitely some old desks, that's for sure. Looks like they would have bolted down to the floor. Now, I can't really get in this room too easily, but I believe that engine is known as Big Bertha. I'm assuming it's a turbine of some sort used to power operations at the mine. I read somewhere online, I think they started this thing up in recent years. Oh, here's an old blacksmith shop. Bunch of interesting old stuff in here too. So, this is not a real mine, I don't think. I think this is just here for fun. You can walk in there, and we will. But the real mine that exists here on this property is actually right over here. That is the original mine. So yeah, I was told that they actually did plug the mine so you can see dirt in there. I think it's a 10-foot plug, but that shaft is actually over 1,000 feet deep, according to the signage here, but for insurance reasons, they did have to plug it up. So yeah, this is a mock mine. I was just told it was actually an old semi-truck trailer, but it's fun. You can kind of walk in here and pretend you're in a mine.
So I was kind of walking around and ran into a guy that actually works here. He has a lot of really good information about this place and cleared up a few things for me along the way that I was wondering about, one of which is right up here.
So the building up here is, I believe, the only original structure that was built on the premises. It's an old boarding house that was apparently built in 1909.
Another interesting thing that I was told by the gentleman that we talked to over here is that the little mine shaft we saw, apparently it was not a gold or silver mine at all. It was actually an attempt to dig and prospect for copper. So folks dug and they never pulled anything out of that apparently. And then eventually one of the larger companies did do some sampling of that area and they did find a body of copper down there. I think the guy said it was about 3 foot wide in some places and as wide as 15 feet at its greatest width, but it wasn't enough to be lucrative to mine out, so they never did.
And it's not to say that some of these are not original structures. There are structures down here that are, like that one that says standard dealer, that's an old dentist office. That is actually an original dentist's office that was pulled in here from the town of Jerome, the nearby town, pretty much right around the corner over there. So I think a lot of these buildings are originals. They just weren't built on the premises and they were hauled back here as part of this attraction.
And then some of the buildings here were actually built in the 1980s by the gentleman that kind of founded this as being a tourist destination. So some of the buildings down there are not as old as you might think or as old as they look. Maybe they're built with original stuff, I don't know. But that's kind of the gist of the buildings here. Well, we explored most of the property here. There's still some more vehicles downhill to see, but we've been here for a couple hours, I think now. Saw a lot, and we actually have to hit the road. But if you're wondering, is it worth stopping here? I would say yeah. I had a really good time. Like all the stuff you see here, all the old kind of junk and Americana, the old vehicles, you don't get to see that every day anymore. So to me, it's really worth it. For a little bit of history, like the old boarding house up there, seeing the old plugged up mine shaft, knowing how deep it actually went down, I mean, that's pretty cool. I mean, overall, I would say, I don't think this was meant to be taken like really seriously, like as a historic destination. So it is a little touristy, I would say, but I think it's meant to be. I think it's meant to be fun, and we had fun today. If you enjoyed this episode, please like, share, and subscribe, and check us out on social media at Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram under the name Cactus Atlas. See you next time.